area, this has been, for me personally, having had so many friends, and been such an integral part of our life. I taught school over here at Boylston. I set up the school, a basic education curriculum here for Little Falls. When I first met Ella Zablowski, we were working in the office where I was running the Head Start program for Morrison, Lincoln, and Todd counties. This area's always been such an integral part of my family life growing up, so it's always fun to be, here. So today's forum is on Social Security, and the reason for it is severalfold. One is I have a lot of young people, you know, coming up to me and saying, you know, what is it with this Social Security? Will it be there for me and my generation when we go to retire? What is it about these plans that are being advanced to privatize Social Security, essentially turning it over to Wall Street? What's this about turning Medicare back over to the insurance companies? And those are all, you know, issues that are being raised, and they're resulting in a lot of questions being asked by a lot of people. And so I encountered some people from the private nonpartisan Citizens Federation, and Representative Buddy Robinson is here from there, and they've been doing, and Buddy in particular, been doing a lot of study on Social Security and Medicare, and I thought it would be very helpful to all of us, myself included, to have a series of forums to try to help us analyze where Social Security and Medicare are at, how they got here, what their future looks like, and what some of the alternatives that are being proposed would mean for us. So from my own perspective, I mean, I always felt that Social Security and Medicare were not entitlements. I always viewed them as earned benefits that people started paying for the first day, the first hour that they ever went to work, and therefore, you know, have every right to expect that they would be honored. And I felt that way for a variety of reasons. One is which that Social Security has never missed a payment in its history. There's never a year when Social Security hasn't yielded a profit. Well, you know, everything has its administrative challenges and difficulties. It's administered for a very, very small percentage of the total cost compared to the way a lot of other things are administered. And so, you know, and it's lifted, you know, more people into a comfortable standard of living than perhaps anything that's ever been done anywhere in the history of the world. And the same can be said, in my judgment, for Medicare. You know, there's lots of things to be upset about, and we are upset about, rightfully so, and a lot of things that need fixing. But it's also important to be mindful of some of the progress that we have made. And I want to remind everybody here, because some of you are at least as old as I am. And in our grandfather's time, the life expectancy in this country was 47 years of age. Think about that. 47 years of age. And today it's darn near 80. And we practically doubled the life expectancy of the American people in a little over a generation. I mean, that may go down in history as one of the greatest achievements in the history of humankind. I mean, Homo sapiens have been on the planet a long time. And to think that in one generation we like doubled the life expectancy, no offense intended, but most of us wouldn't be here if we were where we were, you know, 40, 50 years ago. So, and a big part of that has been Medicare, getting people the health care that they need to stay alive and, have a lively, healthy life and have some income from Social Security to go along with it. So with that in mind, I want to introduce Buddy here, but before I do that, we also have someone here from the Social Security Administration, Jeff Marsh. Jeff, where are you?
I'm right here.
Here's Jeff right here.
Yep.
So Jeff is much more expert than any of us on technical aspects of Social Security. So while we're here today, if we have some technical questions, I hope we can call on you, Jeff.
Yeah, absolutely. Yep.
And
after
the meeting, if people have some technical questions, can you stick around and help us with that too? Thank you, Jeff, for being here. So I'm going to ask Buddy to make his presentation, and then we'll open up the meeting for comments, questions, and just see where it all goes. So with that, please give Mr. Robinson a nice